Hello and welcome back to another game on Arena 1v1 between JonSlow playing in green as the Chinese and it's T90 official in yellow as the Turks. This is an unrated or unranked matchup. I think T90 was in JonSlow's stream and then just decided to join in the game. So they're playing an arena game with Chinese for JonSlow and T90 official with the Turks here. Interesting matchup. Chinese should be a little bit better maybe, but really depending on how good the players are and how they're playing this out, we could see any result. It's the third time that I'm trying to cast this game, and two times the game crashed on me, like in the middle of the game or something like that, so I know most of the game now. I hadn't known it in the first time because I just was going to spectate and then be fine with that. But okay, let's see if the game is actually going through. I hope that as I'm planning to upload this just before Hidden Cup 3, that T90 is not going to face any of these problems, but you never know, and it could happen, obviously. I hope there's no new update coming over the next few days, because that would really screw him up, but I'm pretty sure that as Microsoft is sponsoring this tournament, Hidden Cup 3, that it's probably not going to happen. They are, in the end, not the dumbest persons in the world. They actually know what they're doing, usually. And, of course, we're not really completely happy about how the game turned out, but it's pretty decent and I hope it's going to be improved further. I'm still hoping that we're going back to Woobly someday, having a new World of Kingdoms patch, user patch, what so on, but yeah, let's find out. As for Hidden Cup 3, there's no arena, obviously, so we won't see that map played between the top 16 of the world, more or less, but the players don't really mind that, I guess. They don't really need the arena here. There's not too many among them that would like to play arena, so I guess that's okay, and therefore having T90 official play a game on arena, actually something that you don't see often, that's a nice start for me into this week and beginning on Thursday, obviously. Let's go for the maps now, see what the players are dealing with, and then we're going to see a little bit of an aggressive game here, actually, because what can you do with the Turks? You don't want to go into post-imperial age, then you're lacking the trash units, and maybe with aggression in castle age, you're trying to do damage. We have T90 official going without gold, as far as I remember here, at least not early on. He might take a little bit of gold here from the main gold, but he has the main gold forwardish. Main stone on the side is forward, second gold on the side here, not too far in the back. Both players on the way up to feudal age, actually. We have the second stone and the third gold on the left-hand side outside, and there is a relic on the right-hand side here that's close to him. We have an extra stone not so far away, extra gold in the neutral zone, relic in the neutral zone. We have another extra gold, extra stone in the middle, relic in the middle, and the last two relics closer to Chun's low space, one on the left-hand side here, second stone outside, main stone forward on the same side. Therefore, Chun's low is going with the castle here, actually protecting the stones. And we have the main gold on the other side forward, relic outside, third gold outside, and the second gold on the side here inside his base. Not too far in the back either, so pretty symmetrical actually, which is interesting. The map looks quite fair, a little bit of a scout fight, looks like T90 with the better ends for himself, not sure. Yellow is number 4, JonSlow with green number 3, so apparently it's not priority or whatever that was happening, not sure about it. T90 now 6, 7, 8 villages on stone and 3 on gold, but I remember he only went to gold after or just when clicking up to castle age, so I think he sold some stone in the end. And we're going to see T90 going aggressive, JonSlow 6 villages on stone here and 4 villages on gold with a lot of wood in the bank, so he will be able to go for a second TC. Pretty much immediately, and he is going with that castle, I think, next to the main stone. We have the TC coming up first, and now there's 650 stone to go for that castle that he wants to have here. We have T90 official, actually, and that's something that JonSlow does not know. Going forward with the castle, JonSlow cannot see this, because if he could see, we could have seen it as well. And therefore we're going to have an aggressive game. Lightcap still around, attacking the walls now. That's nothing special, to be honest. It doesn't indicate any form of aggression. Now JonSlow can see the castle coming up. He is going with Chukunu. He is going with the second TC. I don't think he's going for TC number 3 anytime soon, instead of Siege Workshop coming up. If that castle wasn't around, maybe he would have gone for that. And for Chukunu against the future Nisris here, 3-4 now. The wall's going down, actually. T90 is saying, okay, let's chop some wood because I will need it. And the Janissary is now going in. There's a watchtower coming up. It's not finished yet, but T90 won't be able to stop this one. And there's two canoe with already fletching and Bodkin. So JonSlow quickly went for those upgrades. Lightcap went down, one Janissary, but also two canoe dying here. JonSlow has a ram inside, so he wants to go against this castle, actually. Could have been a mangonel. So T90 maybe is noticing that there is the flags on the siege workshop. He's got a siege workshop as well with the mangonel inside. Village is going back to make the build the first extra TC. Yeah, for now he's one TC, so this is the second TC for T90. It's not going for pure roll in. And at this point in the game, I was wondering, the first time I was seeing this, could we go for fast imp here? But neither of the players really doing that. Janissary is going in, killing two villagers in the process, but now they should go down the Chukunu. Three Janissary is not enough to be able to take this fight. And the Manganalo hitting the watchtower, but as there's no villagers around, it needs to stop or needs to be repaired. Like this, it would be going down. JonSlow, how many ramps? That's three. And the siege tower actually coming up. We might see sneak here. Is he going for a siege tower attack here with the Chukunu? Let's keep an eye on that. In the meantime, JonSlow, villager wise 43 against T90 48. So T90 is ahead on villages actually. And is not going for more Janissaries. Instead, Janissaries moving in to try and find some victims, but on the right hand side of the back here, no villagers whatsoever. JonSlow going with the quick walls here, but he's gonna lose these villagers, or not, no, he's actually saving them. At the same time, the Chukunu getting dropped in and doing some damage. T90 seeing this, but he cannot really do anything against it, so the Chukunu should be able to find maybe some victims at least. Those farms are. Is that a bug here? I guess it's a visual bug. In the meantime, Janissaries went to kill a few of those villagers here, and JonSlow has a lot of idle time actually now, and only 46 villagers, while T90 with the siege workshop back at home going for the mangonel here is with 61 villagers, and that's because he's got a 30 C now on the main gold as well, and nice mangonel shot. So actually T90 putting out an economy here, nobody going for the fast imp. JonSlow has that second castle up to protect the main gold, and now he's got 7 plus 1 ram coming up, so 8 rams to take down the castle. Chukunu still around, and T90 actually forgot to take the goose here. That's quite funny. Was in my attempt before, I was seeing the goose standing to the back here, and apparently he didn't actually take it. We have the rams now being prepared. A lot of food in the bank for JonSlow. Should go for more farms here, to be honest, but he's concentrating on the Chukunu micro. They're going down to the scorpion now, and the rams in the meantime are going to do a lot of damage on the castle. Chukunu getting dropped out of the siege tower to take down those mangonels. Nice attack here by JonSlow. This castle is falling. T90 though has another castle up in the middle of the map here, and now I think players should be thinking about Imperial Age as JonSlow is taking down this castle. A lot of gold in the bank, not so much food, and that's a mistake for me because he could have gone for more farms for a long time, but now he's taking down all that forward here, and JonSlow not in a score lead. That's due to the fact that he doesn't have economy. He's not producing any villages. He's just saving from peerage now, and that's one of the weaknesses I think that JonSlow has when even when playing arena. He doesn't add in too much economy in many games, and is, yeah, most of the times actually losing because of that. I've seen it on Gold Rush or Golden Pit, where you're going for the middle, you're controlling the middle, but then your opponent is going for so much economy that you can A, sell resources for gold, and B, just go for so many trash units that you are actually not able to compete. And like this, both players now are on the way to Imperial Age, but T90, 96 villagers against only 53 from JonSlow, and that's big, because even if you lose the castle, if you lose the middle, you can go for a lot of units here. You could go for hand cannoneers, you could go for Janissaries if you have castles left. And then, of course, there's the option to go for siege ramps, for bombard cannons, for hussars, which are upgraded for free. And it looks like we're going to see stable and archery range. Interesting. Not sure what the archery range is for. Does he want to go for heavy cavalry archers? That's also an option, which should be decent against even Chukunu. Not sure about that one. And JonSlow is the first to be able to be up to Imperial Age. He's going for double trebuchet here. Wants to take down this castle and possibly the TC first. And the ram's not really doing a lot here. Maybe cap ram would be an option, but JonSlow is low on food. As for T90, he's going for triple siege workshop here, going for bombard cannons. Has two castles, one inside his base. And ooh, is losing a few of those Janissaries. The Chukunu moving forward. They have bracer done, missing chemistry, missing rocketry, and the lead upgrade. that's okay for this point in the game. Hazara's getting produced by T90, he's got a decent amount of gold in the bank, can go for more bombard cannons. The trebuchet is now hitting that castle, JonSlow even going with a forward castle now. Interesting to see, he wants to claim the middle, there's no extra resources left actually. Hazara's moving in and bombard cannons attacking the castle now, but the Chukunu moving forward, I guess T90 has to go back here. Losing one bombard cannon, nice shot here. And now we have an army of trebuchets and Chukunu against Hazara's and bombard cannons. I'm not sure what's better here, I guess the numbers decide. If you have a lot of bombard cannons, the Chukunu, as long as there is a little bit of a meat shield before the bombard cannons, the Chukunu have a hard time to compete here. Now JonSlow is moving back to take the stone, his castle is safe for now, and the TC is going down as well as the monastery. Relics didn't really matter in this game. A good amount of Hazara's here, 1490, and he's going for more. Housed on 145 though, as he lost the castle. Chukunu now moving in, and those Chukunu should be able to deal with the Hazara's quite well. But there's the bombard cannons firing from distance, and therefore JonSlow has to go back here. I think I can slow down a little bit. Hazara's moving in now to try and take down the trebuchets. They are going down, definitely. Hazara's with plus 4 defense against 12 attacks, so it's not like they're too tanky against Chukunu. But the Chukunu getting caught in the middle between the Hazara's and bombard cannons. The trebuchets actually dying, and yeah, T90 is taking a really good fight. Hazara's 95 HP, they are surviving for quite long, and those Chukunu are elite, actually. Against the rocket, I guess with the rocketry, they would be fine, but like this, and rocketry actually coming up, T90 has a very good position, and he's now going with 6 bombard cannons to attack the castle in the middle. Only 2 trebuchets to defend against this, and the Hazara's moving in once again. So maybe JonSlow needed a more economy here, because he's quite behind in the score. Oh, 71 religious is okay-ish, but he also needs pikeman halberdier to be able to defend against the Hazara's protect your elite Chukunu. Like this, the castle is going down to the 5 bombard cannons left, and even the Chukunu have to go back here. JonSlow with good amount of stone, could go for another castle here, but he needs to go for more economy still, and he's producing villages from only 2 TCs. He needed to add in a 3rd TC for quite some time, in my opinion. Did not happen, he was focusing on his micro, and T90 is just spamming now. T90, 170 villages, good amount of resources. He can still go for Hazaras if he wants to, or for Warmed Cannons. He's now going for more stables of producing a lot. Is he actually producing anything? I guess not. A few units now, Hazaras coming up, and a little bit of a ceasefire here, but it's only short. T90 went with the TC on the extra stone, also going for the extra gold now. A monk around to collect some relics, I guess. And again, the only small unit, groups of units moving, meeting in the middle. There is now 8 bombard cannons on the field without the plus 2 range upgrade, but it's not really needed. The Hussars are doing a good job here, and the Chukunu have to be constantly walking, because otherwise they are going to die to those bombard cannons. We have a defense upgrade coming up for JonSlow. Rocketry done, though these elite Chukunu are now fully upgraded on the attack. Not sure about Thumb Ring and how important that one is. And the bombard cannons, 9 of them are going to try to do their best, or T90 is going to try his best to actually take down Chukunu here. Looks like Hazara's again moving in, the Chukunu getting in, split into 2, now 3 groups. That's not something you want to have here. And JonSlow, how many military units do we have? 23 is going for a castle now, but ooh, bombard cannon shots, and from 23, it's going down to 14 really fast. Hazara's moving in, and at this point, JonSlow is calling the GG. I hope you enjoyed this one. See you in the next game, see you in the outro for JonSlow's end here, and GG.
Yeah. And a lot of economy. And bastard. Yeah, that was silly.
Yes.